the studio manager here today. It's his last day. So he's allowed to have whatever he wants for breakfast. And he said he wants last night's curry. Really? You got it out there? He says yes. Okay, that's lovely. Also, we've got ham and spinach quiche drizzled with onion gravy. That's from Rosie. So we've got Rosie and Nick and me. Then we've got dippy eggs with Marmite soldiers, of course. And pancakes topped with a scoop of mango sorbet. It doesn't get better, friend. Good morning to you. This is Love Songs from Radio 2. As the night moves in, love takes on new meaning. If you were here, you would know what I mean to say. A circumstance think it's the penultimate last day of the month. Is that right? Well, anyway, Tuesday is December. On our way to Christmas, look. What'd you say?
Keep this fight.
Speak up, mate. It's Love Tunes, your calls, your emails, details of radio and television and things going on around the UK and the world, and some weddings and some movie songs and all of that kind of stuff.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
I was just going to say that. We'll get right to it after this. It's Foreigner. I want to know what love is.
I've got to take a little time, a little time to think things over. Better read between the lines, guess I need it when I'm older. Mountain I must climb, feels like a world upon my shoulder. Through the clouds I see love shine, it keeps me warm as life grows colder.
Andrew, Helen and Stephen, would you wish our son Daniel happy 18th birthday? Daniel, happy 18th. We would have been having a family celebration meal out, but due to the lockdown, that couldn't happen. I know. Daniel is a fabulous son, grandson, big brother and friend. He's always there, willing to help if he can. He loves playing guitar, listens to loads of music, jazz, 60s, 70s, the lot. We'd love to hear him mentioned on your program and help him have a great day. Thank you from Carol, Andrew, Helen and Stephen. Here's a Facebook from Rebecca Mary. Let's have a look at this one. It says, hello, Steve. Hello, Rebecca. Can you give a shout out to my wonderful mum, Jen, who's celebrating her birthday today? I love and miss her so much. She lives in Pembrokeshire and I live in Swansea, so it's been hard not seeing her much this year. And I hope she has a wonderful birthday. And I can't wait until we can form a Christmas bubble in a few weeks. That's from Rebecca. And here's Joe Payne. Hello, Steve. I'd like a dedication for my hubster. Hubster. Yeah. Keith. It's his birthday on Tuesday. That's December 1st, you know. Can you wish him a very happy birthday and send him all of my love, as he's a star and I love him very much? That would be from Joe. Here's a beautiful, beautiful song. Another love from Tom O'Dell.
I wanna take you somewhere, so you know I care, but it's so cold and I don't know where. I brought you daffodils on a pretty string, but they won't flower like they did last spring. And I wanna kiss you, make you feel alright. I'm just so tired to share my nights. I wanna cry and I wanna love, but all my tears have been used up on another love, all my tears been used up on another love, all my tears have been used up on another love, all my tears have been used up.
Songs from Radio 2. There's Tom O'Dell.
Another love.
A bit powerful.
Steve Wright's Love Bites.
Yeah, thank you, Tom. Greg from Exeter is dedicating a song to Jess for her amazing support and love over the years. She's been the light at the end of the tunnel and kept Greg going as he wrote his thesis. And Kate Bashford is dedicating a song to her lovely boyfriend, Sam. You all right, Sam? All right, Kate? He's going away for a few weeks with work, and she's going to miss him loads. And Sanjay from Manchester wants a song for an intelligent, strong, caring and beautiful lady called Claire. Sanjay loves Claire very, very deeply and misses her so much. You got it.
Steve Wright's Love Bites.
More of those later.
Steve Wright's Sunday Love Song.
Is that you, Sarah?
Your tea time DJ needs you.
Sarah Cox. Weekday afternoons from 5.
Your tub-thumping tea time extravaganza. 2 hours of music to make your wibbly bits wobble and your heart soar. Glide up the red carpet at the Sarah Awards. Get misty-eyed with your first and last and move and groove to the Wower. The biggest belting sing-along at home song.
Check this out.
Sarah Cox. I'm excited. Zippy
that guy
excited.
Needs a lozenge.
Come on, let's have it.
Weekday afternoons from 5 on BBC Radio 2.
Thank you.
Can't get you off my mind.
It's Miley and Dua Lipa.
Lord knows I tried a million times, million times. Oh, oh, why can't you just let me go?
Strung out on a feeling, my hands are tied. Your face on my
that? Dua Lipa, Miley Cyrus, Prisoner. Sue Perkins sitting in for Michael Ball this morning, joined by Steps. Elaine Page on Sunday, that's a one. Johnny Walker's Sounds of the 70s at three. Paul O'Grady with triples from Britney Spears and the Stray Cats, plus a lost TV theme. Hello?
Good morning, Steve. My name's Gary from Haworth, West Yorkshire. I was wondering if it was possible to have a dedication for my wife, Laura Campbell, who has just retired this week after 38 years, and it's time now for her to relax, enjoy life, and do the things that she wants to do. That's from myself, Gary, her husband, and her loving son, Fraser. Thank you, Steve. Bye.
Hi, Steve. My name's Angela English, and I'm ringing from Liverpool. I would like for you to play a birthday request for my husband, Jed, whose birthday is on the 28th of November. It's been a tough year, and Jed has supported me. So happy birthday. I wish you all the best. And that comes with love from wife, Angela, son, Jed, and his husband, Matt, daughter, Sarah, and Dixie the cat.
Hi, Steve. This is Craig calling from Dundee up here in Bonnie, Scotland. I would love to leave a dedication for my amazing and wonderful wife, Jackie, who will be celebrating her 60th birthday on the 30th of November. Can I send her all of my love and wish her a very happy birthday on behalf of myself and all of the family, including daughters Ashley and Lindsay, and our beautiful grandchildren, Leo, Lola, Luke, Keris, and Reese. Thank you, Steve. Bye.
More calls later. Facebook from Sasha Manning. Morning, Sasha. I'd like to wish my husband, Danny, a very happy first wedding anniversary. We've had to cancel our honeymoon this year and also our one-year getaway, but we're both grateful. We got hitched last year and not this year. Oh, yeah. Lots of love from Sasha Manning. Here's Roger Contello in Connecticut, USA. Hey, Steve, this dedication is for my wife, Diane. We're Brits who celebrated Thanksgiving this last week with our children Liv and Christian in the USA. Diane and I listen to all of your shows every week and make a special point of listening to Sunday Love Songs. Diane is an amazing wife and mother who's the glue of our family, and she just started a new job too. Excellent. We got much to be thankful for in these crazy, crazy times, but top of the list is my gratitude to be married to Diane and the family we share together. Sending loads of love to our family and friends in the UK. We'll be over as soon as we can. Thank you from Roger. Okay, you got it. It's two guys with a glint in their eye. To all the girls I've loved before. It's Julio and Willie.
To all the girls I've loved before.
Loved before.
Who traveled in and out my door. I'm glad they came along. I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before. To all the girls I once caressed. And may I say I've been. For helping me to grow, I owe a lot I know to all the girls I've loved before. The winds of change are always blowing, and every time I try to stay, the winds of change continue blowing, and they just carry. Who now are someone else's wives. I'm glad they came along. I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before. To all the girls who cared for me.
faithful, who travel in and out our door. We are glad they came along. We dedicate this song to all the girls we've loved before. We're glad they came along. We dedicate this song to all the girls we love.
That's Willie Nelson and Helium. To all the girls I've loved before. Wow. There's two guys with different lifestyles. Email from Eddie. It looks like a Stichinski from Fife in Scotland. Yes, it is. My message is for my gorgeous wife, Linda, as it's her birthday today. Happy birthday, Linda. I was 16 years old when I first saw Linda. I was in my friend's car who knew Linda, and we pulled up alongside her in a bright orange Mini for a chat. Well, I've never heard anyone talk and laugh so much in such a short conversation, and I was attracted to her straight away. It would be another 5 years before our paths would cross again, and the rest, as they say, is history. We celebrated our wedding anniversary last week and have spent so many happy years together. Our life with Linda has been great, and given the chance to live again my life, I wouldn't change a thing. Together we got three sons, Ryan and Colin and Grant, who between them and their wives, Claire, Jane and Amanda, have given us 8 special grandchildren: Emily, Katie, William, Reuben, Lily, Jack, Thomas and Lucy. Thank you very much, from Eddie. Wow.
I found a love.
Is that you, Ed?
For me.
How many Christmases ago was this a hit?
Darling, just dive right in. Follow my lead. Well, I found a girl. Beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. But darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes found a way.
Christmases ago. Was this a hit? Was it last year? Nope. Was it the year before? Nope.
Deserved it. You look perfect tonight.
It was 2017. 3 Christmases ago. Almost. Ed Sheeran.
Steve Wright's Sunday Love Songs.
Morning from Lynn Clark. Hello, Steve. Hello, Lynn. Can you play something slushy for my daughter Hannah and her husband Rob? It was their 10th wedding anniversary on Friday, and they were supposed to be spending 2 nights down here in Cornwall in a posh hotel while we looked after their 2 gorgeous children. Unfortunately, I know. Of course, the dreaded COVID intervened, and this is the 2nd time they've had to cancel their much-needed break. Please also send love to our other daughter, Bryony, her partner Sean, and their lovely daughter. This last year has not been great for them, COVID restrictions aside, but we're all looking forward to spending some time together here in Cornwall over Christmas. Thank you very much from Lynn Clark. Okay, Lynn, do some weddings soon. Here comes Gregory Porter.
Hello, Mr. Holland. And Rosie may come out and play. She's a good girl now. Won't be no trouble, no how. By the way, Mr. Holland, I like the way you made no trouble of my skin. It's not a problem, nor has it ever been. You invited me into your home, treated me like I was grown. I was only 18, and Rosie was a beauty queen. Hello, Mr. Holland, and Rosie may come out and play. I'm a good boy now, won't be no trouble, no how. By the way, Mr. Holland, I like the way you treat me like a regular Joe. I wanted a soda, and you said Rosie could go home. Anyway, I like your style, seem like I'll be around for a while. We can talk about a country mile and listen to a blues record, check it out, oh. Hello, Mr. Holland, and Rosie may come out and play. It's a good world now, won't be no trouble, no. And by the way, Mr. Holland, I like the way you treat me like a regular bill. My name is not a problem, and oh, it never will. Anyway, I like your way. People ought to be able to play and keep your soul as black as the night when you're walking straight into the light. Oh, now. Soul as black as the night, as you walk into the brighter light. Mama used to fear for me, when you go out in the world you see. Some people will fear your face and name, but Mr. Holland don't play that game.
Oh, oh Mr. Holland.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Gregory Porter.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Oh, always treat me right, hey, Mr. Holland.
Tune. Good morning from Radio 2. Here come the weddings.
Steve Wright, Sunday Love Songs. BBC Radio 2.
Sunday morning, the bells ring out. It's getting hitched. Email from Lynn and Alan Bovis. Hello, Steve. Hello, Lynn and Alan. My daughter Melissa and her fiancé Ivar were due to get married yesterday, but like so many others, because of COVID, it's been postponed until May next year. They'd even planned a weekend away to mark the occasion, but this got cancelled due to lockdown too. It would be great if you could give them a shout out today, as Melissa's lovely sisters and close friends have arranged some amazing treats for them to make the weekend memorable at least. Many thanks, Steve, from Lynn and Alan Bovis. And hello to Melissa and Ivar. And I hope this weekend is going okay for you. Email from Mark and Jane Scott. Now, hello, Steve. Could we wish our son Ryan Scott and his partner Shannon Couch, who are getting married on Saturday, next Saturday, at Beaconsfield Registry Office, all the luck in the world, and we hope they have a wonderful day. Love and best wishes from their two children, Junior and Maya, Mum and Dad Mark and Jane, and brother Jason. Shannon's mum and dad Albert and Karen as well, and all family and friends. I think we mentioned them all. Email from Mark, or Marge, I beg your pardon. It's Marge Halliwell. Steve, can you read this message out for a wonderful couple, Mark and Alex? They were due to get married yesterday, but like so many, had to postpone their day until next year. Both are wonderful human beings. Alex is an A&E doctor in Chester, which you can imagine is pretty busy at the moment and demanding, whilst Mark is a passionate ecologist travelling the country with his work. We look forward to being part of their special celebration next year. But in the meantime, please send them much love from all the Halliwells and the Sprosons, including Mark's brother, Tom, and Grandma and Granddad, and not forgetting Nana. Many thanks from Marge Halliwell. You got it. More weddings later. This is two songs in one. Baby, I Love Your Way. And Free Bird, it's Will to Power.
Shadows fall so low before my eyes, and I'm moving across the page. Cause your love
I Love Your Way. Email from Justin Millard from Manchester. Can you please do a shout out for my beautiful girlfriend, Kiara? We met 7 years ago when I was living in Australia, although I'm originally from old South Wales. After a few years of long distance, I moved back to the UK to be with her, and we settled in her home in Manchester. She's my bestest friend. I love her so much, and I don't tell her enough. Also, she recently became the best mother to our red cockapoo puppy, Reggie. Hello, Reggie, who also sends his love. We listen to love songs every weekend. I know she'd absolutely love a mention from you. You're a favourite. You're a favourite, Steve. Thank you from Justin Millard. Thank you, Justin. You can contact Love Songs. Email lovesongs@bbc.co.uk. It's lovesongs@bbc.co.uk. You can call, leave a message for future shows anytime. 03700 100 200. Or you can write Steve Wright Sunday Love Songs, BBC Radio 2, New Broadcasting House, London W1A1AA. Hello.
Hi, Steve. This is Colin from Edchester, County Durham. I would really appreciate it if you can give a shout out to my fab wife, Gillian, who retired on Friday after 37 years of pit work. Unfortunately, due to current circumstances, the usual events to mark such an occasion have been cancelled, but a mention on your show would provide some consolation. Jill really is the best wife anyone could have, and I want to wish her a long and happy and healthy retirement. Thanks, Steve.
Hi, Steve. My name is Lisa. I'm calling from Nottingham and would like to send my love to my husband, Jez, whom on Tuesday, the 1st of December, we will have been together for 30 years. He was my rock through lockdown one, and I love him very much. He's been a wonderful husband and father to our gorgeous sons, Isaac and Jacob. Thank you.
Hi, Steve. My name is Martin Racher from Kingsworthy in Hampshire, and I want to wish my gorgeous wife, Fiona Racher, a happy birthday for the 1st of December. I want to tell her that she really is the rose of my heart and that I love her enormously. I know we can't celebrate like we planned to this year, but me, Eric the Cockapoo and Gertie the Border Terrier will make sure her special day is really special, and when we can, we'll have a really big do. I think that the latest lockdown rules mean that as she can't celebrate properly, she doesn't have to add another year onto her age, but I'm not sure. I may be wrong about that one. Thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
Believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my need. A lonely place to be. So I learned to depend.
them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess in time. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I'll live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all was happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside. That special place that you've been dreaming of leads you to a lonely place for your strength.
Oh, George Benson. Greatest love of all on Love Songs. Wow.
Yeah,
Sophie, Alistair, Mary, Barbara, Michael, Becky, Jesse, Chris, Bonnie, and the rest of the Huey family. Want to say a huge congratulations to Alex and her new fiance Sam, who got engaged last week. Stephen Gibson is dedicating a song to his amazing wife, Vanessa, who's a fantastic mother to Ellie, William, and Barnaby. And Jackie Holness needs a shout-out for her wonderful husband, Jeff. It was their anniversary yesterday, as well as Jackie's birthday today. So happy birthday, Jackie.
Some might say that love is bad.
Go on, Gary.
Might say that you can't get enough. Some might say beware, take care, cause anytime you can dissolve into thin air. Some might say that love is a game, and then some might say get ready for pain. I say if you're feeling the same, take the biggest sauce and empty it into your veins. When your reputation's only fabulous, when your reality is only a dream, and it can, cause it's incredible, absolutely unforgettable. People say it's only chemical, but it can't be. It's incredible what you're doing to me. If I say it all, every word and every syllable, got you high above that is all. And you will see, it's incredible what you're doing to me. Might say love's unpredictable, some might say love's metaphysical. Makes you feel like you're invincible. Once you got the taste, then it's easy to drink it up. Some might say true love is a myth, but some say true love, no, it doesn't exist. If you say that, then you haven't seen this. This love, I tell you, no, I can resist. When your reputation's only fabulous, that's what love is, what it's supposed to be. It's incredible, absolutely unforgettable. People say it's only chemical, but it can't be.
Oh, Gary, how we love you. Incredible, Gary Barlow. We're going to break for news next. We're going to roll up to news with Style Council. You're the best thing on Love Songs.
the chains from me. Oh, the soul I need, baby, you're the best for me. Gonna rock my dreams, but take the chains from me.
We're going to break for news next. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Claire Ronacres.
Thank you very much.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
Love Songs Hour 2.
BBC Radio 2.
Two. Hello, good morning. More weddings coming in this hour. Two great movie themes this week and every week. Some groovy tunes, obviously. Calls and emails and a little survey, a little report. 9 creative ways to say thank you. It's all on Love Songs. Let's perk you up.
everything that's held us down. But now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go. And where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our show together. We're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Well,
don't you let nothing, nothing stand in your way. I want you to listen, listen.
Trying to make it, they only push you aside. They really don't have nowhere to go. Ask them where they're going, they don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're gonna put our show together, gonna polish up our act. Well, and if you've ever been held,
we were just saying the clapping in this is very good.
You refuse to be held down anymore. Well,
and also the boo, 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 whatever that is. I don't know what that is. Nick says it's a syndrome. Not a syndrome. Facebook from Geraldine Savage. I'd like a dedication on love songs for my daughter, Kate Long. Please, she's a wonderful daughter, wife, and mum to her two boys, Joe and Tom. She's my eldest, and I want her to know that I love her so, so much. If possible, can you play her a song? I will. That's from Geraldine for Kate. Steve, could you please dedicate a song to my amazing wife, Julie? This is from Scott Wilkes. We celebrate our fourth wedding anniversary on Thursday. Tell her I love her millions. Thank you from Scowie. And now the love songs continue. Here's Stevie Nicks, Don Henley. This is such a lovely tune. Leather and lace.
Is love so fragile and the heart so hollow? Shadow with words impossible to follow. I knew I'd never want to leave.
it's cold and scared, and sometimes I cry. But that time I saw you, knew what you'd light my nights. Somehow I'd get by.
Lovers forever, face to face.
Stephen X, Don Henley. Elaine's here from 1 o'clock today with lots of lovely show tunes, movie music, another of your onstage mishaps, and she'll be playing 60 minutes of songs that have the word home in them. Like home is where the heart is. And home on the range. No. Driving home for Christmas.
Take from me.
Too soon?
My lace.
BBC Radio 2's In Concert 50.
Time seems to have flown far too fast.
What a nice welcome.
Throughout November, we've been celebrating five decades with 50 live performances from the 70s to today. A who's who of incredible musicians, from Fleetwood Mac and Bill Withers,
ain't no sunshine when she
to Annie Lennox, David Bowie, Beverly Knight, Sam Smith, and more.
Look, we've had a wonderful time.
And time is running out to hear them all.
In Concert 50.
Thank you for coming, thank you for listening.
Download the BBC Sounds app to discover the full lineup.
Okay. We love it when your kids get on and they wish you a happy birthday or a happy anniversary. If you're a youngster, hello youngsters everywhere. And for next week's show, you'd like to wish your mum and dad a happy anniversary, happy birthday, happy Christmas even. You can leave a message on 03700 100 200. 03700 100 200. Remembering that, standard geographic charges apply. Of course, some mobiles may be higher. You could even get permission. But then they would know about it. I don't know.
Hi, Steve. It's Giselle from Tunbridge Wells. Steve, please play a song for my lovely girlfriend, Emma Stilling. I love her loads. We're just about to move in together for the first time in 12 years. And I would love it so much. Lots of love from me to Emma, Jizzy, and love to you, Steve. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hi, Steve. This is Max and Thomas Wright from Hinckley. We would like to wish our mum and dad, Louise and Johnny, happy 18th wedding anniversary on the 30th of November. Thanks.
This is Hayley from Chesterfield. I want to wish a huge happy wedding anniversary to my mum and dad, Sheila and Dave, here in Chesterfield. Lots of love from Hayley, Paul, Gavin and the grandkids. Thank you.
Where's that old friend gone? Lost in a February song. Tell him it won't be long till he opens his eyes. Where is that simple day before colors broke into shades? And how did I never want to let you old friend gone, lost in a February song. Tell him it won't be long till he opens his eyes. Opens his eyes.
Hey, it's our old friend Josh Groban. February song. I love it. Hello, Steve. Hello, Paul Jones. Facebook here. Can you give a massive shout out? And I love you to my gorgeous girlfriend, Sharon Ingleton. It's been a week of worry, but it's all good now. Cheers, righty, from Paul Jones. And here's Richard Pye from Lancashire. You've got to dedicate a song to my beautiful wife, Andrea, who celebrated a big birthday yesterday. She listens to the show every Sunday. One of the few free mornings she gets. And I want to tell her what a fabulous wife she is to me, and mum she is to our children, Molly and Tom. Andrea doesn't realise how much she is the centre of everything. She is kind, selfless, and always thoughtful. Andrea means the world to us, and she would never expect me to ask for a dedication. Not in a million years! We've had to alter plans for her birthday, obviously, but you reading this out on your great show would make up for things. Wow! Are you surprised, Andrea? Thank you very much from Richard Pye. She likes surprises. Love songs at Radio 2, here comes Golden. When you're ready, Harry Styles.
Golden, 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 as I open my eyes, hold it, focus, hoping, take me back to the light. I know you were way too bright for me. I'm hopeless, broken, so you wait for me.
Good one, Harry. Harry Styles and Golden. And so we come to our two movie themes or songs. First up today is the love theme from Romeo and Juliet. Now, this song was composed by Nina Rota for Franco Zeffirelli's 1968 version of Romeo and Juliet, starring Leonard Whiting and Olivia Hussey. And is, of course, based on Shakespeare's tragedy about two teenagers who fall in love but can't be together due to their feuding families. Nino later became known for his work on the Godfather movies, but before then, a rearrangement of his signature Romeo and Juliet track was made by Henry Mancini. This tune also was used on Simon Bates' Our Tune. Another version of the song featuring lyrics and renamed A Time for Us, recorded by both Johnny Mathis and Andy Williams. But this is the popular version. It's the love theme from Romeo and Juliet, Henry Solomon and the orchestra. theme from Romeo and Juliet. Well, next up is Move Over Darling, Doris Day. Move Over Darling is the theme song from the 1963 movie of the same name, starring James Garner, Doris Day, and Polly Bergen. The movie follows James's character, Nick Arden, whose wife, played by Doris Day, goes missing after they're both in a plane crash. After searching for her for 5 years, he decides to move on and remarries. But on the day of his wedding, his wife returns after being rescued from the island where she was stranded. The track spent 16 weeks on the UK singles chart, and years later, it re-entered the charts when Tracy Ullman released her version of the song in 1983. But here's Doris Day and Move Over Darling.
Our lips shouldn't touch.
Move over, darling.
I like it too much.
Move over, darling.
That gleam in your eyes is no big surprise anymore. 'Cause you fooled me before. I'm all in a spin.
Move over, darling.
About to give in.
Day, Move Over Darling. More next week.
If there's one thing that's always seen us through tricky times, it's music. And there's one genre that's been bringing joy to many for generations.
Radio 2's Folk Favourites with Mark Radcliffe.
Join me for a look back at the year in folk, as artists and audiences have had to get creative with the way they've enjoyed the music. With highlights of some of 2020's unique live performances.
And special guests. Radio 2's Folk Favourites 2020.
Available to hear on the BBC Sounds app.
Thank you, Mark.
Steve writes Sunday love song.
Hello, good morning. songs from Radio 2. Hello, good morning. This is Steve. Claire Ferrant from France, or it might be Ferrant, says this dedication is for my boyfriend, Michael Laporte. I met him online during first lockdown via a dating website here in France. We were forced to get to know each other by chats and video calls in a mix of English and French for several weeks. This was a first for me, as I've never chatted to a bloke for so long without meeting up, and we created a good friendship. This was over 8 months ago now, and we're now in the second lockdown, which of course is another challenge. I want to tell him that he's the best thing about 2020 for me, and thank goodness he came into my life to brighten up my year and hopefully many, many, many more. I want to tell him I love him loads, even though I probably tell him that too often, and thank him for being there for me and supporting me through two operations this year and a bereavement too. Thank you very much from Claire Ferrant.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
BBC Radio 2. And now it's time for some more weddings. Getting hitched recently, getting hitched now, getting hitched later. Got a few. First up, email from Sharon and Craig James. Our fabulous daughter Emily James was due to marry her partner, another Emily Brown, yesterday, but like so many other couples, they've had to postpone their ceremony until next November. Well, we can't wait to officially call Emily our daughter-in-law. We love them both dearly, and also our French bulldog grandsons, Pierre and Henri. Thank you, Steve, from Sharon and Craig James. Okay, email from Peter and Andrea Wood. Can you do a shout-out to our beautiful niece, Megan Roper, and her fiancé, Harry Kirk, from Gainsborough in Lincolnshire? Megan and Harry have been trying to get married all year, with every planned date cancelled due to the pandemic. I know. They've shown great humour and resilience, though, managing the disappointments and rearrangements whilst continuing to work in their jobs as essential key workers. They're a fabulous young couple, and we love them very, very, very much. And we know when they do eventually tie the knot, they'll have a wonderful marriage too. Thank you, Steve, from Peter and Andrea. And Penny Pycroft. Hello, Penny. Steve, can you dedicate a song to Katie and Tom, who are getting married next Sunday? It's been a year of highs and lows, but to put it mildly, well, yeah, wondering whether the wedding would ever happen, but Katie has always stayed positive. When asked why she didn't postpone the wedding, she always said it's about showing her love for Tom and she wanted this to be the year. Mind you, Katie nearly didn't get the wedding dress. Her fitting was supposed to be on the 10th of November. But fortunately, a call to the wedding shop on the Sunday before lockdown, they were able to schedule a visit before it started. Yeah, I see what you're saying. My goodness. She's a fabulous, caring daughter, and we're looking forward to officially welcoming Tom into the family. Can you send all of our love to the happy couple from Mum, Dad, her sisters and bridesmaids, Emma and Laura, and not forgetting Agnes the dog. You called a dog Agnes? Anyway, it all works out. That's from Penny Pycroft, and that's for Katie on Tom, of course. All right, here comes Prince now, the most beautiful girl in the world. On Love Songs.
Could you be the most beautiful girl?
one from the sky. I know Mars could not be too far behind. Cause baby, this kind of beauty, it's got no reason to ever be shy. Cause honey, this kind of beauty, the kind that comes from inside.
Could you be,
could you be
the most beautiful girl in the world?
So beautiful, beautiful.
The most beautiful girl in the world. That's Prince.
Reason that God made a girl.
Can you play a tune for my amazing husband, Gordon? It's his birthday on Wednesday. He never asks for anything on his birthday other than a card, but I think a song on the radio would make his day. Oh, Lorraine, I do. We've been married for 15 years, and still after all this time, nothing he does for me is too much trouble for him. I love him so very much and look forward to spending many, many, many more happy years with him. Happy birthday, darling, is the message. That's from Lorraine for Gordon. And from us too. Now, this month, as you know, we've been celebrating 5 decades of incredible live music here on Radio 2. Right now, there are 50 concerts ready to hear on the BBC Sounds app, with performances from the 70s right through to today. You can hear from the likes of Kylie and Luther and Dido and Sam Smith, Emily Sandé, and many, many, many more. You've only got a few more days to enjoy them, so head over to BBC Sounds, where you can find the full lineup. Just search for In Concert 50. And here is a track by Simply Red from their In Concert in 2010. If You Don't Know Me By Now.
Understand me like I understand you. Now, girl, I know the difference between right and wrong. I ain't gonna do nothing to upset our happy home.
You won't.
performance, Simply Red Live.
Steve Wright, Sunday Love Song.
Hello, Paul. Thank you for a wonderful, funny, daft and warm show. You're talking about this one, love.
Spend Sunday afternoon with Paul O'Grady.
Still broadcasting to you from my back bedroom.
On BBC Radio 2.
And I've arranged a maiden around me. I don't mean a young girl from the village. I mean one of those things that you hang clothes on. I haven't gone potty, putting the tent. Actually, that's not a bad idea to broadcast in, is it?
A potty?
No, I could peg a tent house in the front room.
It's Paul O'Grady.
I'm just going to go one minute out of my blanket and get a breath of fresh air.
This afternoon from 5.
On BBC. Radio 2.
BBC Radio 2. Yeah, ooh, that's why I'm easy. I'm easy like Sunday morning. That's why I'm easy. I'm easy like Sunday morning.
We've got 9 creative ways to say thank you. Saying thank you, it says, can be difficult to do, so here are some great ideas. Number 1, make a gift bag. A unique homemade gift bag with a custom note is a simple but heartfelt way to show your appreciation. Number 2, it says, write a poem. It says, find out what their favourite kind of poetry is. Is it haiku, free verse, iambic pentameter, or some other? I'm afraid I don't know. Then write one that expresses why they deserve your thanks. Okay. Number three, give a gift card. Sometimes choosing what to give a friend can be tough. A gift card is a good idea. You can get it online, obviously. Yeah, no, that's a good one. Send a letter. Number four, at this time of year, don't worry about how long it might be. What really matters is that you took the time to put pen to paper. Well, you don't have to post it, do you? You could just do a letter and leave it somewhere around the house or wherever. Yeah, deliver biscuits or cakes is number six. Creating something yourself is a fun and delightful way to say thank you to someone. Make some baked treats. Number seven, put together a flower basket. What are you, a florist? Whether you prefer fresh or artificial flowers, assembling a flower basket, why not? With a thank you note is an excellent way to brighten someone's day and show how you appreciate them. And finally, number eight, do something special for them. And it says, well, take them out to dinner and watch that movie you've been wanting to see. But obviously, it's take them in for dinner and watch a movie indoors. No, come on, there was some good stuff there. Hope you'll be happy together.
Imagine me and you.
See what I did?
I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me, ease my mind. Imagine how the world could be so very fine. So happy together. No matter how they toss the dice, it had to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together. The dice, it had to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together. Toss the dice, it had to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together. So happy together.
Now before we go, something special to do here. Our studio manager this morning is somebody I've worked with for a number of years. He's a studio manager, producer, sound guy. He's very sound, in fact. Nicholas Henry Fountain. Nick Fountain is leaving the BBC after, shall I say how many years? 41 years. Wow. That's incredible. 41 years of service dedicated to radio. He joined the BBC in 1979 when he was just a teenager. Actually, he was only nine. No, not really. And one of his first shows was with Tony Blackburn, although Arnold the Dog was a no-show. His vast career not only covers live shows and music sessions in the world-famous Maid of Ale studios, but countless music festivals like Glastonbury and Reading, Radio 1 Big Weekend and Tea in the Park. He's worked with radio colleagues in London, Birmingham, Manchester, Scotland and beyond. And we all consider Nick a legend and a gent, an absolute pleasure to work with, and that comes from all of us. We wish him the very best in his next project, and that it'll be long and happy. And Nick, farewell, my analog friend, that's Nick Fountain, and thank you very much. Come on then. Absolutely.
to be free. I just wanted you to know I've loved you better than your own candy from the very start. It's my own fault for what happens to my heart. You see, I'd always known you'd go. So you just do what you gotta do, my sweet love. It may mean I'll never kiss those sweet lips again. Hey, that's no mind. Just chase that devil dream of yours. Come on back, come on back. See me when you can. Make it in a hurry. Now I know they make you feel kind of sad. Yeah, say you don't treat me like you should. They got a way, yeah, to make you feel no good. But they got no way to know. I've had my eyes wide open from the very start. And girl, you never lied to me. And the part they will never, never see is the part you've shown me. So you just do what you gotta do, my wild, sweet love. Though it may mean I'll never kiss those sweet lips again. Hey, that no mind. Chase that dapple dream of yours. Come on back and see me when you can. Do what you gotta do, my wild, sweet love. Though it may mean I'll never kiss those lips again. Oh, pay that no mind. Chase that dapple dream of yours. Come on back, see me when you can.
Now I know they make you feel sad, make you feel so bad. Say you don't treat me like you should. They got ways to make you feel no good. I guess they got no way to know. I've had my eyes wide open from the start. Girl, you never lied to me. But the part they'll never see is the part that you've shown me. Oh, it's the part that you've shown me.
Girl, I can understand how it might be kind of hard to love a guy like me. I don't blame you much for wanting to be free. I just wanted you to know I've loved you better than your own kin did from the very, very start.
And that's Love Songs for today. More Love Songs next Sunday. I'll be back tomorrow afternoon, of course, at 2 o'clock. Sue Perkins to follow the news at Radio 2, on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.